rickety clack along main lines, rickety track.
She whispers softly in my ear,
just to say your last name.
Just find a place to make the scent to keep easy.
That's just the way it is.
Sit down, see when things could only get better.
Yet the same in so many ways.
I have no recollection of the last time I came here.
But if we get much closer, I could lose control. And if your heart surrenders, you'll need me to hold.
I wouldn't be myself without you. Take a piece, take a picture of me. I don't care what happens, see, 'cause I know I'm happy.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome once again to Kandu Arts for Sustainable Development's Open Mic for Open Minds. My name is Brian Reid, and it's my great pleasure to be your host and introducer. Tonight is our 129th episode. Of course, we owe a big thanks to our sponsors, our long-term sponsors, the Rivo Lounge in Chippenham and Co. by Tracks. It's been a mad week, hasn't it? Okay. I was going to talk about the continuing legacy of 9/11 on the world, on America in particular, but realistically there's only one subject this week, and that is of course the sad passing of the Queen, a woman who spent her whole life doing what she saw as her duty. You'd have to say by any standards that it did it pretty successfully. It's not really important whether I'm a monarchist or a republican or a communist or any of those words, because the only word that really applies in these situations is I'm another human being, and I'm one of millions of human beings all over the world, in this country and abroad, whose lives have been impacted, not personally by the Queen. I don't feel that I've learned or changed anything. It's just, she's just always been there. She's been, in the words of the Prophet, ubiquitous by her presence. All right, the unspoken, the unseen, but always there. A woman who managed to conduct herself to the highest standards of personal behaviour, I think, that anybody could have hoped for. Also, you know, I've seen enough of her and seen enough stuff gone on to know that she's a woman with a sharp, keen intellect and with a highly developed sense of humour. I can't honestly say, okay, that I'm not saddened by her passing, just as I would be saddened by the passing of a venerable matriarch of any family, no matter where they come from or anything like that. You know, she was the big mama, okay? In terms of Prince Charles, you know, I think that I can't think of anything worse for any one person than to spend your life realizing that the only job that you're going to be able to do, the only job that that's been decided you're going to do, the real role of your life will only happen upon the death of your mother. You know, these things are bittersweet always, aren't they? Like they say, you know, the Queen is dead, God save the King. I'm not going to get into the thorny mythology of monarchs versus elected rulers and all the rest of it. Okay, everybody's heard it, got the t-shirt. All right, the truth of the matter is like, how are we supposed to think rationally and dispassionately about an institution which has ruled this country for the best part of 500 years? You know, whether you, whatever you think about that kind of thing, it just is a fact. You know, the power of the British Crown is a real thing in the world and has been. I mean, I know the Queen is an exponent of what people are called and calling soft power. Okay. But our soft power comes from basically the devotion of the people. You know, I think Prince Philip was the man that said that, you know, monarchies exist at the will of the people. And when the people don't want it anymore, then it won't be a thing. But the outpouring of grief and the understanding and just the sheer legacy of this monumental person that's been in our lives for nearly 100 years. Where most of us, most people, you know, would have an opinion. All I can say is I'm sorry that she's passed away. I'm sure that, you know, she lived a long, full, and at times very happy life, you know, which is all any of us can hope for. No amount of money or position or power can inoculate you from the desperate times that reach us all now and again. You know, the point is, surely, is that, you know, we cope with triumph and disaster and we, you know, treat those two imposters just the same. Because, you know, life is to be lived. And if you don't realise that it's a competition, then you're not even in the game. Because everything's a competition. You know, the most important thing for me is competing with myself and measuring myself by what I want to achieve and what I want to do rather than what someone else is doing and what someone else has done. You know, plenty of room in my life for admiration and for recognition of service, of commitment, of you know, just being a good person. So, you know, I just want to say, you know, that I'm sure, you know, Charles will have the best advice money can buy. Okay. The only problem, of course, with advice is that at some point you got to listen to something. Okay. I don't wish him ill. I wish him well. And I wish the country well, because, you know, now that we've got a new king and all bets are off, all right, you know, I mean, that's the biggest thing about the change, is that this is a huge change. This is a huge change, which means that it's inevitably stressful because nobody knows what follows. All right. We've been dealing with certainty, with the uncertainty or the certainty of uncertainty for such a long time. Okay, but we always knew that this was going to happen at some point. And, you know, I think if you consider what's happened to this country in the last 5-6 years or so, it feels like we've absorbed a series of huge blows. The first of which is the obviously and undeniable effect of Brexit. And wherever you stand on the political scale, things are worse because of Brexit. And the only people who really have got their tails in the air and their heads in the sand are still denying that. But since then, we've had an even more catastrophic thing happen, not just to us, but to the whole world, the pandemic, which has cost us the kind of money the like of which people would talk about, this is how much we spent on the Second World War or something. That's how ridiculously crazy it's been. And we're just about to enter another phase where the fabric of society comes under pressure through the ridiculous mismanagement of oil and gas and heat and energy security that this country is currently in. And the Tories will say they're going to get Britain working. But the truth is they've had 12 flipping years. All right. And all we've done is slide down a slippery slope. And now, finally, at the end of it, the person that everybody's turned to for some kind of modicum of common sense, for some like sort of representation of stability and tradition and all the things that they keep selling us to say, you know, this is what makes this country great. Okay. The truth is that what makes this country great is that there's a lot of good people in it, a lot of good, genuine people, a lot of industrious, a lot of brilliant and educated and entertaining and people who make life better for the people around them. We are constantly and continually under pressure from the forces of darkness and evil and the haters. But that's always been the case. But, you know, in order for to triumph over hate, you can't triumph over hate with hate. All right. No matter how sort of natural that response may seem to be. The only response to hatred, okay, is determination. Determination not to be changed, not to be a hater. Defend, okay, with gusto. I'm sad to see that the Queen is gone, but it was always going to happen, and we were always going to have to deal with it. All right, but one thing I'm not sad about, okay, is the fact that the world changes, the world moves on. Okay, no matter who is here and who is not here, all right, the place will continue without us, and we will continue without the Queen, and we'll look for a surrogate, and we'll hope that Charles can fill those mighty boots. All right, the truth is that the monarchy is a constitutional rubber stamp for a government, all right, and the real power, okay, resides with the politicians, with the people's votes. Let's face it, you know, if we had to vote for a monarchy, well, how would you do that? How do you vote for a king? You can't do that, can you? You can't have like sort of an apprentice style approach to find the new monarch. Okay, you're not going to find a golden child who's been anointed from birth. What we are going to do is hope that, we nourish and we cherish and we're lucky enough to get people in places of power who've got the best interests of the country at heart instead of their own naked self-interest. I mean, let's face it, if you're in the royal family, okay, then you are the recipient of the largesse of the nation. Okay, and the only thing you have to do is give up any semblance of privacy or any idea that you're a private person while you're doing that. I wish them well, and I'd rather them than me. All right, but anyway, the truth is, okay, we've got an open mic to run, okay, and it's incumbent upon me to say massive thank you to all the people that turned up to last week's open mic at the Rivo Lounge. Okay, I know sort of, you know, there's a lot of hoo-ha going on about prices and everything else at the moment. All right, but, you know, even when things are really dodgy, right, people just keep going because that's what we do. All right. I'm proud to be associated with it, and I'm proud to be part of it. And I'm so glad to have you guys as an audience. I just want to say, okay, God save the King, okay? Let's keep the open mic going. Let's keep doing what we do. Let's enjoy that feeling of community and sharing. that's been created and that has been nourished. All right, it's loads of fun. All right, and I love being part of it. Thank you very much. Right now, take it away, you amazing open micers.
There's a grief that can't be spoken. There's a pain goes on and on. Empty chairs at empty tables, where my friends are dead and gone. Here they talked of revolution. Here it was they lit the flame. Here they sang about tomorrow, but tomorrow never came. From the tables in the corner, you could see a life reborn. And they rose with voices singing, and I can hear them now, the very words that they had sung. Oh, my friends, forgive me that I live and you are gone. There's a grief that can't be spoken. There's a pain goes on and on. Phantom faces at the window, phantom shadows on the floor, empty chairs at empty tables, where my friends will live no more. Oh, my friends, don't ask me what your sacrifice was for. Empty chairs at empty tables, where my friends will sing.
This is gonna take a long time, and I wonder what's mine. Can't take no more. Wonder if you'll understand. It's just the touch of your hand behind a closed door. All I need is the love you gave. All I need is for another day, and all I ever knew, only you.
This one is called Your Time Is Gonna Come. Shade inside, she's watching your days go by, letting the others decide. You must convince and fake smile. And the life had turned into a tarnished glass, with your dreams out of sight. The pain eluded in the vessel of time. You think it's over, it's all over, but your life's about to start. Don't be afraid, don't cry no more, 'cause your time is gonna come. Your wounds are gonna heal. I know it's hard, but you gotta find your own way. No one will do just you on your own, and your time is gonna come. Let them down, just by choosing to live your life. And now they look at you with different eyes. They cannot find what they used to find. And the people talk, I know they do it all the time. All alone down Moorland Road, as they were better than you. But don't hear what they say. It is all rubbish, and it has nothing to do with you. Just be kind to them, just turn in love, and your time is gonna come. And your wounds are gonna heal. I know it's hard, but you gotta find your own way. No one will do just you on your own, and your time is gonna come. And you gotta shine, 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 like a star in the dark. Your own way, 'cause your time is gonna come, and you won't have gonna hear. I know it's hard, but you gotta find your own way. No one will do just you on your own, and your time is gonna come. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so if I'm back now, that means we've come to the end of another show, number 129 in our journey. There's lost contributions coming straight into the thing, but there's always room for them. All right, so we're not averse to taking your contributions, but we are of course mining all of the live activity that we're putting on. And using that content to spread the love around. If you want to contribute, then you know the open mic email. It's openmic@kandu-arts.com, we will add you to our massive library of content that's been created over the last couple of years, over the last 2.5 years, more than that. Okay, but right now, right up to the point where the knots are drawing in and everything's being slightly more miserable, not quite so warm. All right, it's time for the guy that's always warm, the guy that's always giving, that guy, Ed Deedigan.
Well, I've been loving you a long time. Down all the years, down all the days. Laugh at your funny little way. We watched our friends grow up together, and we saw them as they fell. Some of them fell into heaven. Some of them fell into hell. So I took shelter from a shower. Is there a fell into your arms? On a rainy night in Soho, the wind was whistling all its charms. So I sang you of my sorrow, and you told me of your joy. Whatever happened to the old song? To all those little girls and boys. Sometimes I wake up in the morning. Ginger lady by my bed, covered in a cloak of silence. I hear you talking in my head. Well, I'm not singing for the future. Of the past, I never think about the first time.
Bye.